What do most people do on a rainy day off from work? Drive an hour away to buy an adult Lego set? That's what I did. No, not that kind of adult Lego set. This kind. This is a 1994 Yamaha Jog with a 90cc two-stroke engine. Here she is in all of her glory, with a box of parts to boot. After installing and hooking up the stator and rigging a carb to verify the bike did indeed run, it was time to head to the magical land of eBay to purchase some Chinese goodness.
Don't trust China! China is asshole!
With shipping these days seemingly arriving whenever the hell it wants to, I was at the mercy of the big three. While waiting on the parts to arrive, I took the time to go ahead and sort out the bodywork before assembly. This included attempting to rejuvenate the 1994 Sun Trash plastics, as well as a quick wash and buff for their painted parts. I did have to fiberglass one small cracked area on the front plastic. Check out this video if you're interested in that process. I was able to bring the plastics back to life with two different processes. Initially, I attempted to reheat the plastics with a dry buffing wheel after wet sanding with 200 grit. While this did turn out well, it was too inconsistent and difficult to not burn areas on smaller parts. For the remainder, I opted to just proceed through sandpaper levels with varying grits up to 2000. Then I dressed everything in a trim oil. Not too shabby. Still waiting on parts from the benevolent shipping gods, Adam and I tried to return this bike to a somewhat stock configuration to tune from. We put on one of the pipes the bike came with and got an interesting result. The bike would idle like a champ, however, we couldn't get the bike to roll off the throttle with any joy, just a begrudged sound. Now, this went on for quite some time, including swapping carbs, needle configurations, float height adjustments, jetting configurations, choking the carb with various filters, replacing the CDI, even as far as grease packing the crankshaft seals, which could cause a vacuum leak in this case design, all to no avail. It was at this point that I decided to do the unthinkable. Resort to asking the internet. Oh man, what a mistake. How could I be so naive? It was unanimously declared it was an air leak, and you cannot under any circumstances run an open carburetor, the internet says. With my newly heated advice in mind, I went to test this theory on the bike. Well, unfortunately, the Mensa division of the scooter world was no help. There was no air leak to be found, hence the rock solid idle. It was 2nd and 26. What a year it had been. Beat down from the ongoing pandemic plaguing this world, Adam knew just what he had to do. He had to go big. He had to bring the trophy back to the ranch and prove to Shirlene and his son Roger that Papa knew how to throw the ball and save their marriage. He threw that Hail Mary straight to aisle 3 in O'Reilly Auto Parts, and with a spark plug tester glowing that dim, unenthusiastic orange under the load of throttle, we all knew it to be true. The stator was dead. So I bought a new one on eBay, and when it showed up, the bike was now alive. Time to slap it back together. If you made it this far, I appreciate you sticking around and watching. If you wouldn't mind leaving a thumbs up or a comment, the interaction really helps my videos. If you would consider subscribing, that would be awesome. That way you can be sure to catch the second part where I reassemble the scoot. See you guys next time.